Hey everyone, this is John Dickinson from motionworks.net, back with another Sapphire tip for you. This time we're going to talk about transitions in After Effects. And transitions in After Effects are often overlooked, but there's definitely more to them than meets the eye. I particularly like using transitions with type, especially the Sapphire transitions, because there's a huge range to choose from. So let's take a few moments taking a look at some of the setups I've created using Sapphire transitions. In this first example, I have this horror text here, which I've pre-composed, and I'm using the Sapphire grunge effect to fill this up with this grungy look. And this is one of the grunge presets called Quentin, which ships with Sapphire. To learn more about how to use grunge with text, definitely check out the grunge tip. But for now, I just want to show you how you can use Sapphire transitions to reveal this text in a spooky way. So first of all, I've used Sapphire dissolve glow, and if I just play this back, you can see how the text is dissolving in, and it's also glowing at the same time. It's got a nice spooky feel to it. And for dissolve glow, all I've done is I've increased the width Y to give it that nice stretch look, kind of a classic horror feel. And I've animated the dissolve percent. If I just press the U key to reveal the keyframes, you can see I've started at 100% and I'm dissolving back to zero. And that's revealing the text, because you don't have to use a transition to transition from one layer to another. You can see here, I haven't chosen a background source. It's set to none. So it's a great way to transition text in. And with Sapphire Dissolve Glow, I've been able to combine a dissolve and a glow into one transition. So it saves me having to add a glow effect and animate that, and also animate opacity keyframes. Let's just turn on this background here. This is also Sapphire Grunge, one of the Sapphire Grunge presets that I've loaded up. And to wipe this off, I've used Sapphire Wipe Clouds. So let's just select this layer and turn on Wipe Clouds. And for Wipe Clouds, I've just animated the wipe percent. See, I've started on zero, and this gives us a nice spooky wipe. So in this case, I haven't had to use something like fractal noise and create a matte and then animate that. I can just apply the Sapphire Wipe Clouds effect and animate the wipe percent. So you can see how the Sapphire transition effects have saved me a lot of time. Let's take a look at another example. In this example, I have this music text and I have Sapphire Wipe Circle applied. Let's just turn that on. And you can see if I just drag through that, I'm revealing that text using a circle. And to create this manually using standard After Effects features would take a little bit of time. But with Wipe Circle, I can just apply the effect and animate the wipe percent, which is what I've done here. To make this look more interesting, I've used Sapphire Wipe Tiles. And you can see I've set the tile shapes to stars. And if this is some sort of music-related thing or television or movies, stars are definitely a good shape to use. So I've combined two transitions in one. Now I've also got this background layer, and this background has Sapphire Wipe Star applied. You can see I also have wipe percentage keyframes here from 4%. We just turn this layer on. From 4%, which fills the frame with red, down to about 87% or 88%, which makes the star just fit inside that circle. So wipe star, not necessarily being used as a transition, but allowing me to create a really quick star shape and animate that in quickly and easily. And I've got one more layer sitting above that, which is also a red solid, and I've got Sapphire Wipe Tiles applied to that. And you can see I'm not doing anything as far as transitions go with wipe tiles, but I've just set it to a wipe percent of about 25. And that's given me this star shape, which is filling up this background. And we don't see that in the transparent areas because I have this button clicked here, which is preserve transparency. That's a really nice way to crop out those areas. So I'm using the transition purely as a device for creating a more interesting background. In the next example, I've created more of a thriller style, and you can see I have this thriller text applied, and I've started off with Sapphire wipe line. You can see I've set the border color to white, and I'm animating the wipe percentage. You can see I'm animating that from 57% to around 38%, just to reveal that text. So that's an interesting reveal, but I've made it more interesting by adding Sapphire dissolve tiles. You can see I've also animated the dissolve percent for dissolve tiles, and that gives that a really nice, interesting fractured look. So combining two transitions together to reveal the text. Now I've duplicated that text and put it on top. And for the duplicate, I have both of those effects applied, but I've just modified the dissolve tiles setting slightly to break the text up even more. Just turn that on and off, just like that, to add a little bit more detail. And then duplicated the text again. And for this one, once again, we still have the same wipe line and dissolve tiles, but this time I've used wipe dots as well, just to fill that up with dots. And you can see wipe dots doesn't have any animation. It's purely used just to fill that top layer with some dots. If I adjust the frequency, you can see I can change the amount of dots in there. So layering Sapphire transition effects on top of each other can result in some really interesting looks. And notice also that I haven't fully completed the dissolve so that we're left with this nice fractured look at the end. Not too much, because definitely want the text to be readable, but that's much more interesting than fully dissolving all of those layers and just having standard white text again. So even if I didn't actually add any animation to this, I could have set this up in this way using Sapphire transitions to get a really nice grungy look to this text. And in the last example, I have this comedy text and I have Sapphire wipe dots applied. And if I just adjust the wipe percent, you can see I can wipe the text on and off. But what I did for this was I duplicated the text a couple of times. And you can see here I have exactly the same text, slightly different color, and a slightly different frequency and wipe percent. And by doing that, I'm getting this kind of 3D or faux 3D look. And then adding another layer and modifying that slightly again, you can see I've made that even darker. That helps even more to make this look like it has some depth. Then by adding the text again at the bottom and actually not applying any effects to this one, you can see that's just filled with this orange yellow. I'm getting this really nice effect where this text looks like it has 3D holes in it. And I haven't created any animation for this at all. I just used Sapphire transitions to create this look. So go ahead and explore the Sapphire transitions, which you can use to add even more muscle to your Sapphire effects library. Thanks for watching, and be sure to click on the link in the description to download a free trial of Sapphire for After Effects and check out these great plugins for yourself. Also follow Boris Effects on YouTube, Facebook, and Twitter to stay up to date with the latest information and training materials on Continuum, Sapphire, Mocha Pro, and all of the Boris Effects products.